Hi students, Namaskaram. Now we are solving our 9th practical problem in the chapter process question. 1000 units of raw materials were introduced to process A at rupees 10 per unit. Direct labor and the other expenses were rupees 3000 and rupees 2000 respectively. Past experience showed that 10% of units introduced to the process were normally lost, which possesses a scrap value of rupees 6 per unit. The actual output from the process was 850 units to be transferred to process B. Prepare process account and abnormal loss account. This is the question. Firstly, prepare process account. Draw process A account with two columns, quantity and amount. In the question, it is stated 1000 units of raw materials were introduced to process A at rupees 10 per unit. It is the material introduced. 1000 units, it is the quantity. At rupees 10, 1000 into 10, 10,000 is the amount. Material introduced. 1000 quantity, amount 1000 into 10, 10,000. Direct labor rupees 3000 and other expenses rupees 2000. These are to be debited in the process account. Labor 3000, expenses 2000. Past experience shows that 10% of the units introduced to the process were normally lost. It is the normal loss at 10% of input. Normal loss is to be credited. Quantity, input 1000 into 10%, 100 units, which possess a scrap value of rupees 6 per unit. The scrap value of loss is rupees 6 per unit to be credited. 100 into 6, rupees 600. Normal loss, 100 units at rupees 6 per unit, rupees 600. The actual output from the process was 850 units. It is to be transferred to process B. This 850 units being the output of process A to be credited process B account 850. In the debit side, the total quantity column is 1000. In the credit side, the total being 100 plus 850, 950 units. Debit side 1000, credit side 950. There is a shortage of 50 units in the credit side. It is abnormal loss. That is, units introduced, input 1000 units. Normal loss at 10%, 100. Then normal output being 1000 minus 100, 900. Our expected output 900 units. We are given actual output is 850. Expected output, normal output 900 units. Actual output 850. There is a shortage of 50 units. It is abnormal loss. Credit the abnormal loss in the process A account. In the credit side, abnormal loss 50 units. Then we have to compute the value of output and abnormal loss. Workings. In the debit side, the total quantity is 1000. Total amount column 10,000 plus 3000 plus 2000, 15,000. Workings, material with all cost, quantity 1000, amount 15,000. Deduct the normal loss with its scrap value. Normal loss 100 units, scrap value 600. Now we get normal output 900, normal cost 14,400. Normal output 900 units, normal cost 14,400. Actual output 1850 units. Abnormal loss 50 units. Then compute normal cost per unit. It is equal to normal cost divided by normal output. That is, normal cost 14,400 divided by normal output 900, we get 16. Normal cost per unit 16. Apply this normal cost per unit to actual output and abnormal loss. The value of actual output 1850 into 16, 13,600. The value of abnormal loss 50 into 16, 800. Credit this actual output and abnormal loss in the process account. Process B account 1850, 13,600, abnormal loss 50 units, 800. Then get the total of account in both sides, 1,000, 15,000. It is the process A account. Then prepare abnormal loss account. We have to debit the abnormal loss of process A. Process A, 50 units, 800. In the credit side of process A account, there is abnormal loss, 50 units, 800. Debit it in the abnormal loss account. Process A, 50 units, 800. Credit its scrap value, 50 units, at rupees 6, 300. The scrap value of abnormal loss is to be credited by cash, 50 units, at rupees 6, 300. Balance the account. The balance is transferred to profit and loss account, 500. It is the abnormal loss account. So thank you.